Today on Trucks, we'll show you what to look for in a new or even used trailer. After that, we have a pro-streeted 1970 C10 Chevy to show you that has no trouble finding the winner's circle at shows all across the country. Then we'll finish the show with a hitch, or at least some important information you need to know about them. That's all today on Trucks.
Hey everybody, welcome to this week's show. Now if you're hanging around with us, you're probably already a truck enthusiast. But even if you're not, most people know there's one job a truck is uniquely suited for, and that's towing stuff. Whether that's a jet ski, motorcycle, or even a custom show truck, getting your toys to the playground also means you have to have the right kind of trailer.
The problem is, most people usually spend a ton of money on their truck and their toys and end up towing those toys around on an old, nasty, unsafe trailer. It usually has bald tires and lights that don't work, and you can forget about brakes. Now don't even act like you haven't used this kind of trailer before, because we all have at one time or another. So this week we're going to show you what to look for in a car hauling trailer, and also how to set up a utility box so you'll have all the tools you need right there where you need them.
For our trailer, we went to Trailer World in Bowling Green, Kentucky, and got one of their Super Duty 20-foot all-aluminum setups that are available with a squared front like ours, or a tapered front if that's what you really need. Now, the entire frame is made of T6 high-strength aluminum, and the floor is made of aluminum as well to help keep the weight down. As a matter of fact, our trailer only goes about 1,600 pounds.
We also had Trailer World outfit us with two 5,200-pound axles, as well as some 8-ply tires so we can carry some heavy loads. Now, anytime you're looking at a trailer, whether it's a brand new one like this or a used one, make sure that you find out the carrying capacity so you don't overload it. Unfortunately, most of us think, well, if I can get it on the trailer, it'll carry it. Well, that's not the case. Also, when you're looking at a used trailer, make sure that you check the tires and the axles, and especially the bearings, because they're almost always neglected.
This trailer also comes with these really slick slide-in ramps that lock into place when they're not in use. It's also been fully wired for tail lights, brake lights, turn signals, as well as load lights to keep everything legal. Keep in mind, if you are looking for a used trailer, take the time to really check out the wiring to make sure everything is fully operational.
Finally, up here on the front, we have this emergency breakaway switch. Now what this does, it activates the brakes on the trailer if your truck and trailer should ever become disconnected from each other when you're tooling down the road. Important safety feature, and most older trailers won't have that. Now, like we said before, we're going to put a utility box on here about this area, so I'm going to get started taking off these D-rings and this light while Mel shows you the box.
For the box, we wanted something large enough to store plenty of accessories, but low enough so it wouldn't interfere with any front ends or bumpers. So we went to DZ and got one of their all-aluminum fifth wheel utility boxes. Now this thing features a weatherproof, lockable top, as well as a low profile design that still has plenty of room to store all the towing accessories we're going to need. Not to mention, it matches the look of our trailer perfectly. Let's go ahead and get it on there.
Matches our table too.
Yeah, it does.
To mount the box, all you have to do is center it up, drill some holes down through the box and the floor of the trailer, and bolt it on. Now, a lot of times when you're using a trailer, you're pulling a project vehicle or something that doesn't run. That makes getting it up on the trailer a major pain. So to take care of that problem, we're going to mount a winch inside the box. So the first thing we need to do is measure where we're going to mount our fair lead roller. Then cut it out with a sawzall.
While Stacy's cutting out the box, I can go ahead and show you the winch we're going to use. It's a Super Winch S9000 electric model that comes with an X9 remote solenoid switch, as well as a handheld remote. Now we're also going to go with their accessory bag. It includes a nylon strap, block pulley, shackles, as well as a good old thick set of gloves. And believe us, all this stuff can really be a lifesaver, so it's all going into the box.
With the hole cut for our rollers, now it's time for the winch. Now we've already drilled holes down through the bed, but that's not going to be strong enough by itself, even if you have a steel floor, but especially if you have aluminum like we've got. So we made this plate out of thick steel, drilled some holes in it to match our winch mounting holes. Now we'll take the winch, set it in the box. Then we'll take this plate, go down under the trailer, run the bolts up through the plate and into the winch. That'll give us plenty of support when we're doing some heavy pulls.
Next up is the X9 solenoid switch that's going to activate the motor on our winch. Now you can mount this thing anywhere you want to, but keep in mind, you need to have good access to it so you can plug in your remote. Now with that in mind, we're going to mount ours inside the box here so we can lock it up with everything else and keep it safe from the elements at the same time.
Of course, to power that winch, we need a good 12-volt power source. Of course, we can always run cables all the way up to the front of the tow vehicle and hook up to the battery, but we don't want to mess with those connections all the time. So we're going to rig up our own power source. Now for that, we went to Mr. Gasket, got one of these battery kits. Like before, we're going to bolt it to the bottom of our new box. Now the neat thing about this setup is it not only holds the battery securely, but also comes with all the hardware to hook it up.
For our battery, we knew we had to have something that packs plenty of power and can recover quickly as well. So we went to Optima and got one of their yellow top deep cycle batteries that's really perfect for this application. Now before you mount it into the box, you have to decide if you're going to use the top or the side post. Now for our application, we're going to use the side post to run the power connections to our winch through the side of the battery box.
Hey man, guess what time it is?
What's that?
Time for a break.
Let's do it, man.
Stay with us, we'll be right back.
Later on Trucks, we've got a 1970 C10 to show you that's about as good as it gets. But up first, we're going to finish showing you how to set up the ultimate toy hauler.
Welcome back to Trucks. Now, if you've ever done any kind of winching, you know that that battery is not going to last very long without some sort of charging system, even if it is an Optima. So we went to Solargizer and got one of their solar battery chargers. Now it consists of a circuit box as well as a solar panel. Now what this does is continually charge your battery to keep it at full capacity, but it also shuts off automatically so you don't overcharge the battery. Now another thing it does, it emits a pulsating DC current keeps the sulfate deposits from building up on the plates of your battery and killing it before it's time. Now this is a perfect application for a trailer. It's only going to be used every other week or so. Now to mount the solar panel, you need to put it someplace where it's going to have access to direct sunlight. So we're going to put ours right here on top of the box in this corner.
The circuit box needs to go on next, and even though it is waterproof so you can mount it on the outside, we're going to go ahead and put ours inside the box along with everything else. Now, Pulstech recommends you keep it as close to the battery as possible, so with that in mind, we're going to put ours right here on the back of the box itself. That's also going to keep it nice and close to the solar panel up on the lid.
The last thing that we need to do is make the electrical connections to the Solargizer, and we're done. Now remember, anytime that you drill holes in the top of the box, make sure you put a little silicone around them so that they don't leak. Now I know a lot of you probably thinking, oh, this thing's phony, that's not going to work. Well, all you have to do is grab these two ends when that panel is in the sunlight, and you'll get a shocking reminder that this thing actually converts solar power into electricity.
The last thing we got for our trailer we're definitely going to want to keep in the box is a good set of straps and ratchets. Now keep in mind, these pieces are going to be securing all your toys to the trailer, so you don't want to skimp in this area. We got some longer straps with hooks on the end that'll tie right down to the brackets on our trailer, as well as some shorter straps that'll go over axles or even frames. Now the nylon straps are weatherproof, incredibly strong, and almost impossible to cut, not to mention you can get them in just about any color you want.
Finally, we can show you how this custom towing box is going to work.
You all set back there, man?
Yeah, we're clear. Go ahead. One last thing, make sure that the load capacity of your winch is compatible to the weight capacity of your trailer.
Hopefully now you have plenty of good ideas that'll help you build your own safe and functional new or even used trailer. So stay with us. We got more trucks for you right after the break. Man, it sure beats pushing it up, doesn't it?
Yeah, I'll tell you what.
Later in the show, the guys are going to run into a few hitches, class 1 through class 5 to be exact. But after that, they take a look at a Chevy C10 that'll take your breath away.
Thanks for staying with us, everybody. You know, when it comes to truck design, some are just destined to be classics right from the start. And nowhere has that been more true than in the 67 through 72 Chevy truck design. With their smooth, almost car-like styling, people started customizing these rigs almost immediately.
Now, these days, both customizers and restorers are all drooling to get their hands on one of these classic Chevys. Now, of course, the most popular seems to be the short wide body. But if you really want to tuck some fat tires onto one of these things, step side is hard to beat. And nowhere is that more evident than in Gary Donegan's 1970 Pro Streeted Hauler.
The first thing that catches your eye is the super slick laser red paint job and the direction Gary decided to go with this project. Now, you won't see any shaved door handles, emblems, or billet grills on this truck, but what you will see are all the factory pieces, including the bumper, restored to absolute perfection, which gives you a real good idea just how nicely these original pieces all work together.
Now, the hood is an area that has an estimated 300 hours of labor in it. Of course, it's as straight as an arrow and all the seams are right on, but it's not obvious where all those hours went until you slide it forward on a hinge that was robbed out of a late model Buick and tilt the whole thing up. By the way, this is not the direction these hoods were originally intended to open. Now, under the hood is a full house big block 454 punched out to 468 cubes, and that's enhanced with all the necessary hot rod parts to really make this thing run. Of course, comfort hasn't been forgotten either, with power steering, power brakes, and air conditioning.
Speaking of comfort, the interior is no slouch either, thanks to these big black leather seats that were borrowed from a Caddy. The dash and instruments were fully restored and detailed to retain the stock look. Now, power was added to the door windows and vent wings, as well as the back glass. Behind the seats, the stock gas tank was removed and replaced with a flush mount speaker box for a hot stereo system.
Body modifications on this truck are few, but the ones that were done are as tasteful and well executed as the hood. Now, on the driver's door, we have a Frenched power antenna because they're just cool. And if you're looking for the gas cap, forget it, because it's hidden behind a pivoting side marker light that's opened by remote. At the rear of this thing, the tailgate has been modified to open sideways, and those are Ford Model A taillights, just to make people ask questions.
The bed is also up to the same standards the rest of this truck carries, with its polished bolts, red paint, and stainless strips. But the real eye catcher is the handmade black walnut planks that make up the floor. Now, the rear fenders we alluded to earlier are stuffed with huge tires that are bolted to a narrowed 9-inch rear with disc brakes.
The stance of this truck is right on the money, with a nice rake and the nose down in the weeds. Now, that's done with spindles and springs that results in a 4.5-inch drop in the front, and the rear is held by adjustable coil springs and trailing arms to get that right look. Now, finally, the exhaust blows out through these evil-looking tips that poke out in front of the rear tires.
Well, after taking a serious look at this pickup, it's pretty obvious to us why it makes that trip to the winner's circle at just about every show it enters. Stay with us, we'll be right back.
Up next on Trucks, we've got all the information you need to know about Class 1 through Class 5 hitches. Just can't get enough of trucks? Check us out online at truckstv.com.
Welcome back to the shop. Now, like we said before, most truck enthusiasts eventually are going to want to tow a trailer with their truck or SUV. The question is, what kind of hitch do you have to have to tow safely? But that's just it. Most people don't know. So we're going to show you what kind of options you have.
That's right. And the number one rule is you can't tow more than your vehicle's rated for. So the first thing you need to do is find out what your truck's towing capacity is, as well as the gross trailer and tongue weight.
Now you're ready to choose your hitch. Now for that, we went to Hidden Hitch and got a sample of what they've got in all five classes. Now first up is a Class 1. Now this is a light duty application, usually goes on a small car or a minivan, has a gross trailer weight of 2,000 pounds, and installation's pretty simple, usually to the back of the frame or the bumper.
Up next is a Class 2 hitch, and as you can see, it's a little more stout than a 1 and has a capacity of 3,500 pounds, which is perfect for medium-duty towing with a car or even, once again, a minivan. Now, one of the coolest things about a Class 1 or 2 hitch is that usually they're a lot smaller than all the others, so once you have them mounted, you can't even really tell they're there.
Now we have a round tube Class 3. This is where things get a little more serious. Now these are rated at 5,000 pounds and actually need to go in a full-size pickup or an SUV. You can see the construction's a lot more heavy-duty than what we've seen so far, and application definitely needs to be bolted to the frame.
Now a Class 4 is similar to a 3, but ups the payload to 6,000 pounds. Also, the overall construction is a little bigger and stronger, but the major difference is the mounting points. As you can see, they're spread out to help evenly distribute the weight on your truck's frame.
Finally, we got the Class 5. Now this is the big boy. This is rated at 10,000 pounds and obviously is for commercial or heavy-duty towing. Now you can see this thing is built out of very thick steel, all kinds of plates and gusseting for support, and the mounting points, just like the Class 4, go all the way up the frame. Now, installation of one of these guys is a two-man job and usually involves drilling the frame.
Well, that's going to do it for rear-mounted hitches, but if you ever decide you want to tow something heavier than 10,000 pounds, you need to look into a fifth wheel or even a gooseneck. But whatever you decide to tow, make sure your equipment can handle the payload capacity.
Now, when it comes to maintenance, most of you are pretty good about changing your oil every 3,000 or 4,000 miles or so. But when was the last time you changed the oil in your differential or your transmission? Didn't know you had to do that, did you? Well, it might come as a surprise to you, but most of the major manufacturers recommend changing those oils every 30,000 miles or so. The spark plugs, every 10,000. And these old spark plug wires that you never touch, they should go after 50,000 miles.
And now Truck Gear, parts, tools, and equipment for pickups and sport utilities.
Now, if you've been hanging around the sport truck and SUV market a while, you've probably noticed a trend towards larger diameter tires, with 20s pretty much being the norm. Well, Toyo Tires is up the ante with their brand new Proxxis STs that'll handle a 23-inch rim. That's right, 23 inches. Of course, you don't give up any of the great performance or good looks that the Proxxis ST is famous for, and if you don't mind dropping about $550 a tire, you'll definitely grab some attention when you hit the street with these.
Nothing quite sets the look and attitude of your truck like a custom set of wheels. Of course, up to now, that involved a lot of measurements and a fair amount of guesswork. Well, Wheelworks has changed all that with this measuring tool. Now, it gives you an exact measurement of the size of rim that you'll need, from backspacing to width to the diameter. So, if you want your wheels to fit right the first time, then Wheelworks is for you. With a price at about $425, it won't take long for this to pay for itself, especially if you own a tire shop.
If you ever thought it'd be cool to build your own Ford Lightning, believe it or not, now you can. Of course, it's a little smaller than the factory version, a tenth scale to be exact, but it still has some really cool features like all-wheel drive and independent suspension, as well as enough speed to live up to the Lightning legend. Now, Ford Collection offers everything you'll need, including the truck, radio, and battery charger for about $250. Now you really can drive a Lightning without the payments or the speeding tickets. That's going to do it for Truck Gear. Here's a preview of next week's show.
We'll dive into the cab of the Harry Hauler and show you how to lay down some brand new custom floor pans. We'll also steer you in the right direction on a couple other goodies for our 34 International. After that, we'll introduce you to a pro stock truck pilot who's making a difference in the lives of kids from the inner city of Atlanta. That's all next week on Trucks.
Well, that's going to do it for this week's show. We appreciate you hanging out with us.
Yeah, we got more trucks for you next week.
All right, man. Track is set.
Ow. Forget those cones, man. These are wheelie monsters.
Oh, I see. No cones. Woo, what happened to my steering? Eee! Ah!
Trucks is an RTM production.